All right, here we are on April the 14th in Washington at John Paul II Cultural Center, and we're just about to begin. It is 9:15 a.m. They were discussing the route. Washington police here.
New York's
where are we?
Let's do this. As you start walking down, before we get to
the okay, here we are. Here's David, our driver. Let's pull. Say hello, David.
Hello.
And
Dee Dee.
And we have Dee Dee, David's wife. And
so let's just pull Foster out of the district. Have Foster come out. And if 3 or 4 you need somebody, we got three cars and one D have to take care of. So then you'll have the 4 of you in a car. So work it like that. Could you do me a favor and give Foster a call, tell her to meet us up here? I think we'll be good. And in the meantime, if you need any other assistance, just give me a call. And I can have them drop somebody. And I might be able to have them drop somebody who can be part of the whole
thing. She had a partner, right?
Yeah. No, she's by herself right now.
She's by herself, okay.
Yeah.
So you're going to need somebody to stop it going and somebody on the other side.
Yeah. Well, what she needs to do is before they cross that street, she gets in the middle, she stops all traffic.
Stop it all, both sides.
Lights and sirens on, stop all traffic, and nobody moves until she moves out the middle of the street. Right. So we just need her. And then, of course, you guys, as you're walking with them, pull up in the middle, stop, pull the yellow shirts, let them cross, and then always keep one up front, one in the back. The two in the middle can rotate back and forth in between the streets. The same way we do a escort. Okay? Make sure that we get
handle all the. So are you prepared to drive the?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay, good. So that way I can take pictures. And it's a 4 kilometer walk, so. Or a 4 mile walk.
Yeah, and we'll kind of roll up and kind of keep an eye on and assist as we go.
Help with that, people that are.
So if you stay in an area, you see the cars can come around.
We gotta go switch cars. And then what we'll do is I'm gonna call you on the phone, we'll meet you, and so we'll all be just kind of out there.
Yeah.
So they'll have ample
coverage
out there.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm not taking any chances.
No.
Okay. All right, so we're gonna go drop this car, switch cars, get another car.
JR,
you're going back. You good?
Hi, I'm David Wright Smith.
Hi, David.
George's coordinator.
Okay.
And we've done this 1,000 times, so.
We're just going to make sure that we give you what you need.
You know, that's wonderful. We're really, really appreciate the fact that you're here today. It just makes it much easier for us, and it also lends a lot of legitimacy to what we're doing too, with having you guys here.
I was telling John, I believe in what you're doing. My husband is on the donor list for kidney.
Is that right?
Yes.
Oh, that's wonderful.
Are you?
Congratulations.
Oh, beautiful. Beautiful, God is good. All the time.
First year anniversary.
Fantastic.
Something for organ donor.
But he's 9 years out.
He's a trio.
Triage?
Yes, he's a trio. Yes.
He's
organ recipient.
So are we.
Yeah.
Do you mind me asking?
Kidney. Yes, sir.
Liver.
How are you? Hi.
David.
Hi.
This is David.
Trio.
He's going to be part of the southern leg of this.
Heart transplant. She's doing quite well. She's gone through some changes, but she's still here. She's very vital.
That's incredible.
Yes. I've been out 8 years.
Yeah. 8 years?
8 years.
And I've been out 15.
Wow. 15?
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm at 13.
Mm-hmm. 13, eh?
I did dialysis 6.
Well, this is better than dialysis, isn't it?
Yeah. Who you
telling? Amen to that one.
You know,
oddly enough, during the early years of dialysis, I used to fish a lot.
Mm-hmm.
And you would test how I used to take off, and
yeah.
I'd just go fishing.
Yeah.
You know, I had great social workers. I would set up my dialysis, take two, usually an extra day. I could do it in 3 days. I could go fishing. I'd go out in the ocean. I'd come back with grouper, snapper. I had a good time fishing. And then I'd come back, hit the dialysis machine.
And doesn't it give you time to think about everything?
Everything.
Yes.
Awareness is what you're doing. It's very important. Awareness.
Well, you know, the whole idea is to get 50% of the population to sign their donor cards or have the donor sign on their driver's license, and we'll eliminate the need to wait.
Yeah.
Right? That's the thing, right? That's the whole thing.
My daughter told all her friends that when they get their license, they have to be on there as a donor or she beat them up.
That's one way of doing it.
And she got a couple, a few of them did sign up for it. She's going to beat them up.
Okay, fear works.
Fear.
We'd like to think that they would do it out of
compassion, out of
we know exactly why they did it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and we understand why your daughter would resort to those tactics as well.
She told everybody at school.
Okay, I'm gonna go drop off the car, pick up another one.
All right. Yeah. You want me to take the truck?
Yeah, you're done. You're done. Yeah.
Okay.
And thank you for everything.
Just one.
If you call me, I'll pick you up from down there if you need me to pick up the bus.
Do we have an order in which we're we're moving? I guess David would, he's going to be driving the ambulance, and just so as we know.
Because he said he wanted to do this. He wanted to film from the back of the truck.
Yeah.
While the people were walking. So
yeah.
That was fine. As long as he had something to hold him in there. That's all we wanted.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, in the truck, you mean?
In the truck, yeah.
Well, yeah, because it's busy.
Yeah.
It's going to be busy going in.
We're going to follow up in the ambulance, so we'll have the two bicycles in the front, and we're gonna. I'm having another car pull in. Also, we'll have two bicycles in the middle, and especially in the major intersections like New York Avenue, going straight down, we'll have the car stop all traffic before we cross. Make sure there's nothing going on before we cross over there, and then we will kind of be following up and kind of falling in where we need to.
Okay.
So sure.
Thank you so much.
Okay.
No problem. So we'll be right here when you get ready to go.
And I'll be back. I'm just going to switch cars.
Okay. There we go. We're on record. Alrighty. All right. David and Dee Dee are here. And David is going to be doing some driving during the southern leg of this journey in the fall, correct?
Yes.
And so he's come on. And he is a heart recipient of 8 years, and you're looking pretty healthy, David. It's nice to see.
Yeah, feels good.
So here we are on April the 14th, as promised. George is inside with his laptop, and he's coordinating things, and we're setting up for our meeting this morning. And then what we're going to be doing is walking with a couple of dozen, anyway, students from the Washington, D.C. school district, and we're going to have a police escort, and we're going to be walking 4 miles down to Capitol Hill from here, and hopefully we're going to have some interest from some Republican and Democrat politicians, and we just want to see them shake hands this morning on this very important issue of raising awareness for organ and tissue donations. And it's not just about donations, it's about transplants and how essential, vital, and necessary they are in the medical community nowadays. So here we are. This is April the 14th, 2010, in Washington, D.C., at the Pope John Paul II Cultural Center. Let's see if we can get a shot of this building here. It's a beautiful morning compared to yesterday. And when I was a kid living in Toronto, I used to come down here to Washington, D.C., or actually Arlington, Virginia, which is just a few miles from here, correct?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And this feels like a very similar kind of, I'm getting that feeling of when I was 10, 12, 13, 14 years old coming down here. Just the look, the feel, the air, it's taking me back to that time, and I'm really enjoying this morning. And it's going to be a nice 4 mile walk down to Capitol Hill. This is our last event now until September, when I'm not sure if I'm coming back, but George will be coming back to Washington to start off again on the world tour that is being announced this morning. And that's why we're here this morning, is to announce the world tour.
Oh, that's pretty.
Yeah, here's a reflecting pool. And we're walking down to the reflecting pool in Washington, which is right in front of Capitol Hill. Good morning.
Outside, but feel free to come in, walk around, or whatever you'd like to do this morning.
Morning.
How are you?
David?
David. John.
John, right. I knew that, but I didn't want to say for sure in case I was wrong. Nice to see you again.
Good seeing you too.
Nice to be here.
Ah, what a beautiful day.
Compared to yesterday, was it raining here all day yesterday?
It was.
Yeah, it was raining all the way down.
And I thought, when I saw the sun this morning, I thought, okay, well, this is going to be great.
It's nice to see the sun on the reflecting pool instead of the rain.
Yes.
Although that kind of has its own look as well. Oh, there's George. He's hard at it as usual. Okay, George, say good morning.
Good morning. Good morning. This is a great morning, actually. I'm trying to get the podcast going.
You're probably sitting in the sun.
No, there's no other way. Everywhere I turn, there's sun.
Right.
They got me.
Okay. Well.
But I'm hard at it. I'm going to take a look at the torch.
Yeah.
Just to make sure it's, you know what I think.
One of our policemen is a kidney recipient.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
You want to see him? Oh, I got to go talk to him.
Yeah. Well, I thought they were just coordinating the...
Okay, David, here's the... if you want me to... Because I need you to be in full focus here, so I can take over the camera or have somebody else. So, Luis, you got a pen?
Yep.
A pen.
Me too.
Okay, we can actually just put this down here just for a sec.
Luis, he's the tour guide that took us around, eh?
Yeah. So he's going to be, maybe, if it's not, but you won't have to worry, I'll just put him in here. So me, okay, if there's any political, that's, you know, I haven't seen any community, I'll ask the officer. And religious, I guess I haven't seen. So Glenn, Aaron's coming. David, did you tell me if he's going to say a few words?
I think you did.
Yeah, but we have to go to them, you know, right now. This is your job from here on, just to get to all these people. See if you can put the officer's name under community, if he would like to say a few words, and then get his name.
Okay.
Thanks, David.
Thank you.
Good to see you again. How are you? How are you doing?
Not too bad.
Ready for your run today?
Yes. You're prepared to say a few words?
I could, yeah.
If Dr. Dempsey doesn't arrive?
I will do that, yes.
Okay. It's just basically introducing the place.
Okay.
And just to talk a little bit about what we're doing.
Okay.
And then you can pass it over to me. George Marcello. Just, yeah, a few minutes of greeting.
No problem.
Okay, perfect. Sounds good.
Yeah,
yeah. I heard. Now we're live right now, on the world. The world is. This is a live webcast as we speak. People can tune in. If you got relatives or anybody friends, phone them in. Tell them to go to stepbystep.ca. And as long as we don't get any technical problems, they'll be able to see this whole thing. Oh, and David. You're prepared to say a few words, right?
Yeah.
Okay, good. David will call you up, the other David.
Okay.
You know, it's step by step what?
Dot C-A. C as in Charlie, A as in apple.
Okay.
Hi, Stephanie. Good. How are you?
Good
to meet you.
My house is a ladies' room somewhere.
Right? In the ladies' room. Hello, guys. How are you feeling today?
Good.
Good, good, good. All raring to do your thing?
Yep.
And you must be
Alex.
Good to meet you. So David already spoke to you and everything?
Yep.
Okay.
And
so you guys are ready to do the whole 4 miles? Yep. Okay, good, 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 good. Good stuff. You guys ever been here before?
Yep.
Yeah, good.
When did you guys come?
I just came around my
house. He's not here now anymore.
Here's the brief.
The police? Oh, okay, okay. Okay, so David's going to say a few words, and Aaron's here, so you can tell him. He just went to the washroom. Somewhere, wherever the washroom is. Yeah, that's the agenda. I think you have the agenda with you. Luis, is that?
Oh, see you again. Nice to see you.
You too.
That's the agenda.
Okay.
So did you guys hear what the other kids are doing with their chant? If you guys can join in, that would be great. While they're walking? Yeah, it's Preparatory School of Washington, D.C., I think that's the name of the school. Preparatory. So when they're carrying the torch, they'll probably give it a few practice runs here as well. They're going to start chanting, donate your organs, let's go. And then everybody claps, donate your organs, let's go. And then the other one is, I say organ, you say donate, and anybody yells out, donate, you know. So if you guys can get kind of in the swing for that. But here's another question I'm going to ask, because I'm going to ask your school first, because I'm going to. Who would be willing to go, because we have an ambulance with a mic on it, and we need a lead, someone to lead on the mic, you know, to start chanting that. Do we have any brave souls here, by any chance? Are you reporting for duty?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Can you hold on 1 second, then? David, did he show you how to use the microphone? Because we got a volunteer that's going to go on the mic.
Yep.
Maybe if we can do some practice runs with him, get the car started, and then
well,
he
we're
can.
Right up front here. So
okay. So, David, sorry, what was your name?
Garrett.
Congratulations. David. This is David.
That's David.
Okay.
David as well. All right.
Can we go out to the truck so he can get kind of a practice run?
Oh.
Yeah. We want you prepared when. And you could mention the two schools or whatever other school. So far there's two schools, Preparatory School of Washington, D.C., or just Preparatory School of D.C. And we're going to give it a few practice runs. Go ahead, jump in. And it's Garrett, right?
Yes, sir.
Garrett. Yeah, right there. Because I want you to get as comfortable as possible. Roll down the window. Okay, so start her up, David. Let the light go on first.
Yeah, I know.
Okay, so that mic, you push it in. Push it in. Go ahead, talk.
Nope,
not yet. Wait up. You have anybody you can phone to go to stepbystep.ca? We're on live.
Oh, live?
They could see us live right now.
Wow, yeah.
We're live. Let them know. Let them know. Go to stepbystep.ca and they can watch the whole thing. .ca. C like Charlie, A. Step by step. .ca. Good to see you too. .ca.
.com?
No, that's it.
That's it.
Yeah, that's the Canadian for .com.
Okay.
For a com, yeah. So we got 10 minutes. I'm going to make sure the torch looks good. In about 5 minutes, can you have all the officers come in to tell them that we're going to begin the speeches in 5 minutes?
In five minutes.
Yeah, tell them. When it's 5-2, say in 5 minutes we're gonna.
Donate your organs. Donate.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Oh, let's go.
That's okay.
What do you want to do?
public today, normally on Tuesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday.
David, do you know where the torch is? Oh, okay. Okay, I'm gonna bring it up. I'm gonna designate one more student to do something. Okay, camera work.
Oh.
Is that okay?
Yes.
It's very simple, actually. This has a 7-hour battery, so don't worry about the time. Here's the zoom button. Try putting your hand. It's recording right now, so you don't have to touch anything. Okay. Feels comfortable? So at the reflection pool, we're going to get around to every student, asking them how they felt about everything and their thoughts on all the donations.
Okay.
And then who would they like to pass the torch to if they had a wish that could come true? Who would that person be?
Hello?
It could be a celebrity, it could be another person. You know, just
okay.
Who would that, and then, because we have it recorded, we try and make that wish happen.
Okay. You guys want to think about that before we get there?
Think about what?
Once we get to the Capitol, they'll just quickly film you saying, what is it again, who would be?
If you had a wish,
I wish to pass the torch on to somebody else.
Who would that be? Could be a celebrity,
family member.
Could be a rock star, or could be a person that, who needs it.
The only comfort book is that I already take your cash in.
Yeah, so Diego.
There's someone really cool we could pass the torch on to. Like, because we gotta think of someone that's like the best
person.
Are
you recording us?
Yes.
Oh, cool.
Sweet.
Hi.
This is Viva.
Right, so guys, let me get a picture of you guys by the,
The pool. Let's get it by the pool.
By the ambulance here.
Oh.
Okay. Oh, I gotta whip out my camera phone.
Let's see. There's something on the door itself, right?
Yeah,
go ahead and shut the door so you can get the whole thing.
Let's see, menu.
Truck of life.
And let's get the truck of life thing there. Right now. One, two,
poopy.
Three. One more for good luck. One, two, three. Alright, next. Let's see.
Alright. Gary, let's go inside.
I
Oh, Garrett, we need to do the pose everywhere.
Oh, yeah, totally.
Dang.
You think that'll work?
I don't know.
Oh, that worked perfectly.
We'll see.
And
you have a... Let's go. Oh, the elementary students are here.
The elementary students are here.
Okay, where's Garrett? I'm sorry, I gotta get the names right. Garrett, right? This is Garrett. These kids are gonna come out. They already got the window going down. Before we go in there, see if you can get them back in there. I'm gonna see if they can do a little rehearsal with you. Sounds good.
Okay, Diego, you ready?
I'm ready.
I say dish shoot, you say donate.
Donate.
Dish shoot.
Donate.
Yeah. Oh, man.
We need 50 cc's of epinephrine stat.
All right, Washington Park School.
Hey, Garrett.
Hey, Jank.
You all have two kidneys left, right?
Move.
I say organs, you say snatch. No, donate organs, it's cool.
Jank, Jank, Jank.
Anyway, this is an ambulance made for people who are shorter than I am, or people who like to bend over, I guess. But I guess it's fine. It's got a nice stretcher.
Yeah, this is a shame for me as well.
How'd you grow so much taller than me?
No, it's the TV of life.
How'd you grow so much taller than me?
Here, move, get out.
Did I?
Roll out. Oh, this is like a television. This is my main man and yours, Garrett Hansen.
Oh, I want to give a shout out to my Diego.
And there's Rima.
Oh, Ben. Ben's fine.
Say something. Who do you want to pass the torch to if you really could?
Oh man, Saint Benedict the 16th. He's my inspiration. After Jesus.
Pope Benedict the 16th?
Pope Benedict the 16th.
You said saint.
He's not a saint yet.
Oh, did I say saint?
He's not a saint yet,
but I'm sorry.
It's okay.
This is like HD. Look, I can't like read that license plate. Like with high quality. And I can see all the blemishes in your face.
Beautiful, my beautiful face.
Beauty. It's a beautiful face. Hi.
Hey.
Hey.
Hey, so sister.
Thank you, Garrett. Let me see what I look like.
Anything for the ball.
I said only.
Yes. That's too far in.
Okay, guys. You pumped for today. It's a good day for more. I understand we have some cheers playing out. You want to go over those real quick? Want to
try? Dude, if only this were Tweed. He's got the bow tie, but not the hair.
Why? Who am I supposed to be?
Diego Jones.
What?
Name your first kid, Dave, and I'll give you $100.
You guys are all going to come in on the way back.
Alright.
You just have to hang on to something.
Okay.
You know. But you guys will be okay, right?
Yeah, it's fine.
Yeah, you guys.
Bima, I think you should drive.
Over.
Well, I should drive. I have my license on me.
You can't drive this though.
Yeah, I can.
You need a special license.
No, you know. It's not much bigger than a van. I'm driving.
No, I don't think that's a good idea.
Where is that guy?
Where's who?
I don't know. What is this like?
Record. Can you see that? Record.
Yes.
So go ahead. You're back in action.
All right.
Back to your phone.
All right. We are back online.
This is
How do you like it in the truck of life?
Oh, it's good. This is the table for on-the-spot kidney donations.
I don't think that's what it's for.
Oh, okay.
Yes, it is.
And what about you? What's your name? What's your name, mister?
My name's Alex.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is.
Yeah, it's Alex.
It's Alex.
Look how silly you look.
I look sexy.
Hey, you know what? This is a PG-rated video. I'm gonna have to ask you to recant that.
I am looking fine.
All right.
Yeah, he is. How are you gonna ask me?
You're not worth my time.
Yeah, I am.
Hey, Dave.
Hey, Garrett.
Did you get the other schools too, other kids?
Other schools are here.
That's Archbishop Carroll.
Archbishop Carroll, and the Washington Preparatory School.
Exactly.
I'm sure some of the kids wouldn't mind hamming it up for you.
Oh.
We're all gonna go inside now, you guys.
Okay.
David.
What's good?
Nothing's good for you. You're not in my video anymore.
It's gonna be weird when I'm watching it.
This is how all the pros do it.
Not totally.
What's happening? What's good?
I guess so.
You're ruining my frame.
Diego, get your movie director.
Say, I'm so scarred.
Scan the whole crowd. Just go around, scan the whole crowd.
Garrett, it's a different Garrett.
Oh, it's a different Garrett? Okay.
That was good, you were ready.
Hey, yo, Bimo, get out of the way.
It's just easier to put it, you know, G-A-R.
Is that yeah, that's right, because that's how you spell it.
Oh, I don't want to do this.
You tired of it? You can pass it around.
Do you want
to? I'm out, trade you.
Sure, go ahead.
Do the cheers? Or?
Can you walk around a little bit? Just make sure you get
walk
everybody.
Around, just check. Get up close and personal.
Yeah.
You ask them their names, about their personal lives. So how are you feeling today?
Where's the Zoom button?
It's this little thing.
Okay.
Recording?
I think I want to zoom out.
Is it recording?
Yeah, it is recording.
Don't blink.
It's good.
Hey,
As we're signing the what's our prayer here.
Sure, not even gold.
I can understand its social habits.
All right, go around. You have to include everyone. Don't be rude.
Excuse me. He's very...
Just go up to someone. Hey, is there anything you want to get off your chest?
Diego is a very antisocial creature. He'll viciously attack us in a minute here. Oh, jeez. Getting ready to pounce. We should back up. He's attacking.
Hold on, flip it around. I want to see.
You know, Matt, they put this on the internet. You gotta say thanks to that, some kids are the stupidest people around.
Go
know?
Include everyone.
So.
Hold on a second. Oh,
right, someone else.
Yeah, sure.
Ah.
Yeah. I'm the social butterfly here. Everybody asked us to make a little video and everything, so does anyone want to do a shout-out or something? How's it? How's everybody feeling today?
Doing good.
All right.
You kind of sick? Good night. I just had
to. All right. Hey, Diego, you want to get this?
As the clock ticks and ticks and ticks until these organs arrive. Now, here's the good news. The good news is that if we can somehow manage to inspire half the population of America to become organ donors, nobody needs to die on that waiting list. And that's our job today. Our job is to make inspire, recruit as many people, not only in Washington, D.C., but throughout America to become organ donors, to sign that organ donor card. One person can save up to 8 people's lives. That's how powerful this is. So today, the torch of life will be lit here at Pope John Paul II, and Miss North is holding that. The torch is got quite a legacy. For the past 10 years, this torch has literally gone through a lot of parts of the world and been carried by millions of kids. On September the 5th, 2001, that torch somehow made its way to Vatican City, where Pope John Paul II blessed that torch. And when he blessed it, he said organ and tissue donation is a genuine act of love. Genuine act of love. And the other thing that he said that was just as important, he said, pass the torch to the students, for they are genuine. And for the past 10 years, that's what we've been doing. So All the students here today are young ambassadors for organ and tissue donations. It's going to be through your passion, your enthusiasm, that we're going to inspire everybody, and we're going to give hope to those hundreds and hundreds of thousands of Americans that are waiting. And that's what our job today is going to be. At the end, we'll explain exactly the route and everything with Captain Shire. But right now, I'm going to turn it over to David Wrightsmith, who's going to be introducing some of the special guest speakers. Thank you so much for being here. Let's have a great day today.
Good morning, everybody.
Morning.
It's really, it's an honor to be here this morning, and it's wonderful to see so much enthusiasm of so many people here today. I'm just here to introduce folks, so without further ado, I'd like to introduce Mr. Aaron Bell.
Good morning. I'd like to first of all do a general introduction in the form of a greeting to acknowledge the act of humility as well as the respect that's needed in the presence of this memorable moment here today. First of all, I'd like to thank all who have assembled, all who came out this morning for this cause and for this purpose. I just want to commend you, just say thank you. I'm going to just give a brief introduction of myself in regards to being the newest member of the step-by-step team in America. I'd like to extend a appreciation to my wife, Ms. Stephanie Bell. She's here in support of me. I would like to also extend appreciation to the Culture Center for their presence and for their hospitality that they've shown me and shown George as well. And I just would like to say thank you for all who came out this morning again. It truly is a very emotional as well as a very inspiring moment here this morning. So I would like to say again, thank you. I just want to give a brief introduction on how I actually became a part of this team and how I actually became a good friend with George Marcello. I actually had the opportunity of meeting Mr. Marcello at a banquet that I was the keynote speaker at. And when I met Mr. Marcello, I didn't know anything about organ, tissue donation. I didn't know anything about step-by-step or anything like that. I come from a impoverished African-American community in East Baltimore, where everyone out of my community is either dead or in prison. I come from a community where there is not a lot of information made available to younger African-Americans in my community, so I knew nothing about organ transplant, I knew nothing about giving up of something to help another individual, but I just want to share this brief testimony with you so you can get a chance to understand how I became enlightened and how I became enthused by this whole process. I actually met George at this banquet, and George walked up and George gave me a newspaper from his event that he did in Baltimore, carrying the torch through Baltimore, and it actually was in Delaware. And George walked up and gave me this paper and gave me his card and he said, give me a call. And something was so illuminating about George's spirit, his passion, his focus, his conversation was so illuminating that when he talked to me, he changed my whole perspective on the way that I view my life. And in my conversation with George, George began to elaborately explain to me, he didn't recruit me or anything like that. He basically just shared his experiences with me about what he went through and about some of the things that he's doing with the foundation. And I felt automatically compelled to go straight to Motor Vehicle in Baltimore and place where it says on my Maryland driver's license to be an organ and tissue donator from that point moving forward. At that point, I've always checked no, I just want my driver's license. I've never got a chance to understand that there's something that I have a responsibility to do to help save others' lives. And it's more than just to just occupy space and time. It's also needed to be an active participation in making sure that I give back just as well as it was given to me. So when George enlightened me and made me aware of that, I asked to come on board. And he's welcomed me on board and he has given me all of his love and all of his support. And I've placed my love and my support behind him, as well as another brother that I believe that has a passion for making all of us, the whole entire United States, Canada, all throughout the world, aware of how important this issue is. And as I begin to start to study and do my research on this issue, I'm really seeing the political side, I'm seeing as well as the economical side, as well as the ethical side of the disadvantagement to us not being aware of giving out organs and being aware that how important it is, not just to race, but we need to be there to be a part of changing the world by making sure that regardless of what it is, who the heart or the organ or the tissue goes to, that's to save another's life. So it's nothing greater that I have to save with my own life to be able to give of myself to help give another life. So I'm just humbled, I'm grateful, I'm honored. I don't have a lot to say because I'm a newer member to the team, but I just would like to say that just because you're here today, we just want to say thank you. We appreciate you coming out. We appreciate everything that you've done, and we want you to just educate others about this cause. This cause is something that we need to spread all throughout the world, especially in the community where I come from. I made a conscious effort to start a base in my community to start building awareness about organ and tissue transplant donation. And I'm honored, and I'm getting a lot of support. There's a lot of people that are supportive of what we're doing. And I just want to just commend you guys. I want to thank you. I want to thank George. I want to thank all the facilitators here, as well as the officers and those who assembled. I want to thank you guys for your support. Take care. God bless.
Thank you, Aaron. Very inspiring. Before we bring one of our newest members up here, I'm wondering if we could get Dr. Hugh Dempsey to come up and say a few words. Thank you, Dr. Dempsey.
Thank you. I am the Deputy Director here, and it is an honor to welcome some old friends and some new friends to the center that is named for Pope John Paul II. If you know anything at all, you don't need to know a lot, but if you know anything at all about John Paul II, you realize how critically important to him was life and young people. You guys in the front row, you were what kept John Paul going when he himself was sick. If you recall the last year of John Paul II's life, which was 2005, you were just beanie babies. But 2005, he was so, so sick. But what he reached out for was not old people like me, but to young people. And on his deathbed, what he said to the men that were surrounding him and the nuns that had come to see him was, "I went to them, they have now come to me." And what he was referring to were the 4 million young people in St. Peter's Square that were having a vigil waiting for him to go on to God. He blessed the torch that is being carried today. He blessed it because he loved George, and he heard George's story, which is a compelling story, but a story of hope and victory. And he certainly would have loved this young woman, the young woman for whom all this is being done right now. This is a critically important thing that you're doing. It could possibly be the most important thing you're going to do this entire academic year, is walk out this door and walk with George to the next location. It's critical because it marks not just a march, a way to get out of school, a way to get out of English class, or whatever it is, but it marks you as men and women who believe in something that's bigger than you. It's very easy to get real self-absorbed and think, gosh, I'm the greatest guy on the face of the earth, and I'm the most beautiful woman on the face of the earth. But if you think and step back from the face of the earth, we're nothing. We're nothing unless we leave a mark. And today you're going to leave a mark by walking out this door and walking down the driveway, escorted by police. I thought something cataclysmic had happened here when I drove out to all the police. I thought the Pope came back. Because this is exactly where Pope Benedict sat when Pope Benedict XVI visited Washington. Right in this spot. So you are in the room that John Paul knew of. You are in the room where Benedict blessed. And so in a way, Benedict is blessing you on this march as Pope John Paul II blessed this wonderful torch. So God bless you, and God bless you for being outside yourself today and thinking of other people who really need your strength. Thank you, and God bless you.
Thank you, Dr. Dempsey. I'd like to introduce the newest member of our group here today, David Miller, who will tell you a little bit about why and how he arrived here.
I'm David Miller. My daughter saw the ad in the newspaper. I've had heart transplant. It's been 8 years, it's been 9 years, come September 19th. If it wasn't for her, I wouldn't know about this program that I really care about, because if the person who damaged in my heart had not have done it, I wouldn't be here today. I had a massive heart attack, blew out the left side of my heart. I was on an LVAD, which is an artificial heart, for 18 months before I got my transplant. So, you know, this is a major, major thing that we have to get out to everybody in the world. I mean, because if it's not, if we don't, there's a lot of people, a lot of young kids, a lot of adults, you know, a lot of everybody that will not be here to see, you know, their grandkids or great-grandkids or whatever grow up. Myself, I've got 6 grandkids. I want to see all of them grow up. You know, the fourth one was born a week before I had my heart attack. So I am grateful for the people who donated my heart. Thank you.
I'd like to give thanks to, thank you, David. That was inspiring, and we have one of our police officers this morning told us that he'd had a kidney transplant, and of course, you know, that George has had a liver transplant, and I've had a liver transplant also. It's been 15 years, and so we appreciate so much the support that we're getting, and how you folks come up and step up to the plate. Thank you very much. And that leads me into thanking the schools that are here this morning. And the Preparatory School of Washington, D.C. Give yourselves a big hand. Special mention to the Executive Director, Miss Betty North. And the torchbearers, Shawnee and Eric. There they are right here. And I have here speakers. Do we have anybody coming up to speak this morning? Betty, would you like to come up and speak? Shawnee, you would like to come up and speak. Leslie or Jotrisa? Come on up here.
Donor. Good morning. My name is Betty North. I'm the executive director of Preparatory School, and I hold the torch.
Yeah.
It gives me an honor anytime that I can do something for mankind. As I opened up the school about 25 years ago, the preparatory school, I always think it is a wonderful and an honor to be able to give up yourself. And when we talk about organ donors, you are really giving up of yourself. You know, people are afraid that something might happen because they might give it up too early, or I won't make it through, and they won't let me through in the hospital live because I said I'm going to be an organ donor. But that's not how it works. The doctors have an oath that they'll do as much and as many things and as all the things possible to save you. But sometimes enough is not enough. So what you can do in return is to give up something so somebody else can live a little longer. And because you are young and you have the time, you can spread the word. So it's up to you to get out there and tell other people about what they can do to make life in the world much better. We all are part of this world. We are representing God. And he said, go out and help my people. That means you're him. He's in you. So it's up to you to do the right thing. Leslie wanted to say that she was afraid to tell you that her grandfather gave both of his eyes to two different people so they can see. Don't be afraid to give up yourself so somebody else can live a little longer. Thank you.
Thank you, Betty, and for somebody who didn't want to speak, you did a great job. Okay, so we have two other schools that are being represented here today, and I'd like to welcome and thank St. Anselm's Abbey School. Give yourselves a big hand. And Mr. Alex Morris, would you like to come up here and say a few words?
Hi there. Thank you, everybody, for inviting us from St. Anselm's to come over and take part in this great event. Thank you, George, for calling me. And he asked me, I think, to speak a little bit about my sister, who had two liver transplants within the last 15 years. Wow. And I get choked up. So I wrote it down. If it weren't for organ donation, I would not have a sister today. My parents would not have a daughter. My nieces and my nephew would not have a mother. Sorry. My sister Diana required two liver transplants since 1995, and she now lives a full, rich life with a great family. Because two other families, in the midst of their grief over a lost loved one, still found it within themselves to give the gift of life to somebody else. So organ donation certainly gives that gift of life to the recipient, to the actual recipient, but it also gives something very similar to everybody that loves that person. So I thank those families, thank you.
Thank you, Alex. That was really heartfelt. We have one more school that I'd like to thank for coming here today, and that is Archbishop Carroll High School. We're being led on the walk today by Ms. Gilmore. Thank you very much. it's home, you know. It's when we do these sorts of things, this is inevitably what happens. We get choked up. And, I know that I am here today because somebody gave up their organs for me, and I would not have made it past 45 years old if that hadn't have happened. And here I am. I'm going to be 60 in October, and I'm just. I could be at home. I retired 2 years ago. I could be at home, you know, watching Oprah or something. But you know, I'm just really happy to be here today with all you folks and doing this walk into Washington, D.C. Okay, so I'd like to turn it back over to George. So if you'd like to come up here, George.
Good job, Dave. Okay, we're going to just run a little bit late, so I just want to say some final comments before we get Captain Shire to assist me here with the route. I want to thank the following. I want to thank, first of all and foremost, Pope John Paul II Cultural Center for having us here, Preparatory School of D.C., St. Anselm's Abbey School, National Park, Capitol Police is also helping us out, D.C. Police, of course, as you can see. Do we have a fire truck here? Did the D.C. Fire and EMS get okay? That's good. That's what we needed. And also International Limo and Annapolis Holiday Select Inn, and also U.S. Senator Shaheen. She graciously invited us to the Capitol to get this thing going here in Washington, D.C. So is everybody pumped after all that? Okay, we're ready, right? We're ready to do our thing. What I want to say before we get into the route is that the key word is to be careful, like to be passionate, but you know, be careful. So I'm counting on all the elders, all the to supervise all the kids. Our job is to protect the kids, make sure. And also that torch, by the way, this is a pre-kickoff. We're coming back here September 10th to actually launch the world tour. We're going to go through 150 cities in the States and then continue on to 200 countries. So I would like to have you all back here on September 10th. And now I'm going to call Chief Squire to come up to go over the route that we're going to be taking. Thank you.
Good morning. Here's Captain. Thanks for the raise. We go to ensure that you get to your destination safely and without incident. And the only thing we ask that you pay attention to the bike riders who will be riding along beside you, making sure that you stay on the curb and not out on the street, because we was trying to do the street, but they said we put him on the sidewalk because we can better protect you there. So anyway, we're going to file out and we're going down Michigan Avenue to North Capitol and North Capitol straight to the Capitol. And when we get to Third, I believe is Luzanne Avenue, we'll go down and we'll hang a right on the left on Third and go to the reflective pool, which is the circle where the fountain is located. So other than that, any problems come up or whatever, you know, the elderly, that's people that's walking, well, I shouldn't say elderly. Parents. I shouldn't say elderly. Parents and teachers, administrators, you know, just keep an eye. If you see something going wrong, you know, let one of the bike people know and they'll respond. You know, if we have to stop and take a breather or whatever, it doesn't matter, be with you but until you get to your destination.
All right. Thank you. Okay, now if we can all slowly make our way in front of the Pope statue, Pope John Paul II statue over there for a great big group photo, and we're going to light the torch there. Alrighty.
Are we getting in the check of life? What'd you see?
I don't know. I think we're going to go to the thing first. Have numbers.
Thank you for your story, and I love the Benedictine. I spent 10 years at St. Vincent College.
Alrighty. What time is it? It's running late.
10:45. Okay, make sure you're filming. Or you want to be in the photo. I'll get somebody else to do the camera.
Make sure the guy with the bow tie gets in this picture.
Lewis, can you do the camera work here?
Sure.
Do you mind? Are you
no,
sure?
No, I'm fine.
Okay.
Say front up there by Catholic University.
Okay. Good word. Thank you so much. I appreciate it.
I just want to make sure everybody gets here.
You need to get up on the grass.
I will. Sorry.
That's not enough. You're
good. I think you should get in the picture.
You think so?
Yeah. Roll up on the banner. I'm telling the grown-ups to get the picture.
There's John. He's going to make sure that you get up. Can you do it?
Well, then you'll just have to get in front.
Bring you right here. Okay, good.
Get up there.
Go ahead and write.
And you see the people in the back, Luis?
Come back a little further, back.
And you see the police and all that?
Just give me the word, Dr. Dempsey.
Okay, everybody's here.
All ready?
I'm ready.
Okay, we're about to light the torch of life that's going to go on a four-year journey around the world in front of His Holiness Pope John Paul II.
Santo subito.
Yeah.
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 Lots of those, Carlos.
Hold up just for a few more pictures.
I can take over. Thank you, Luis. Listen, I can take over. Thank you.
No problem.
I'll see you after. I'm coming back.
Great job. You did a great job.
Oh, thank you. Okay, I think we're all ready. Okay, we're all ready. Officers, are we all ready?
Yeah, we're gonna go down, I guess, this way.
I'll get David ready.
Get the Jared, too, the guy who's doing the mic work.
March down the drive. Can you get a picture of them as they come down the drive?
I recognized you.
Okay, the preparatory school kids. Are you guys ready with the chant? Richard, are you ready with the chant?
Yes.
To start chant? Give it a practice run now. See if you can get your kids.
When I say organ, you say donate.
Organ.
Donate.
Try it again.
I say organ, you say donate. Organ.
Donate.
Organ.
Donate.
I say tissue, you say donate. Tissue.
Donate.
Tissue.
Donate.
All right, what was the other one? The other one is donate your organs. Let's go. Clap, clap.
Donate your organs. Let's go. Donate your organs. Let's go. Donate your organs. Let's go.
Now we're hoping everybody's going to join in that chanting, okay?
Yes, sir.
He doesn't want to be the only one.
You're going to be the lead car? Okay. Should they be behind you then, or behind the ambulance? Is that on the sidewalk? That doesn't matter, I guess, eh? Okay.
I just want to say something, Drew.
Oh, hurry up.
No, in the camera. In the camera.
Okay.
So here we are. We're just about ready to head out on our 4-mile trek to Capitol Hill. Away we go.
Okay, start the mic.
Hey, guys. Are we ready? Want to run some cheers? Okay, guys. Now, when I say organ, you gotta say donate. Organ.
Donate.
Organ.
Donate.
When they push you, you say donate.
Yeah, you can hold it. Pass it to the kids. We got other kids too that can carry it too. Like if your kids.
Organ.
The other one is donate your organs. Let's go clap, clap.
Okay, here. I think we know this one. Donate your organs. Let's go.
Clap, clap.
Donate your organs. Let's go.
Clap, clap.
Donate your organs. Let's go.
Okay, we're all ready. We're all ready. Are we ready, officers? Are we ready? Yep. Okay, let's go. Start walking. On the sidewalk, on the sidewalk. Okay. Where are you from? Oh, okay. Let's get the mic going!
Donate your organs, let's go.
Clap.
Donate your organs, let's go. Donate your organs, let's go. Donate your organs, let's go. Organs.
I say organ, you say donate. I say organ. It's okay, you'll get it, you'll get
it. I say organ, you say donate. Organ. Organ. I say tissue, you say donate. Tissue. Tissue. Donate your organs, let's go! Donate your organs, let's go!
On the sidewalk over here, okay.
Donate your organs, let's go! Donate your organs, let's go!
Where are they
going to
go?
If they're going to walk on the sidewalk.
Do you want them to get to the sidewalk there? Okay.
Organs. I say tissue, you say donate. Tissue. Tissue.
All right,
guys. Thank you. 55
kids we
got. Let's go. Let's go.
When it gets heavy, you can pass it on to somebody else. Well, he's got to get him going like that. That's good.
I say organs, you say donate. Organs. Organs. I say tissue, you say donate. Tissue. Tissue. I guess I'm three. Big cheer. Let everybody hear you. One, two, three. Organs, let's go. Donate your organs, let's go. Donate your organs, let's go. Donate your organs, let's go. I say organs, you say donate. Organs. Organs. I say tissue, you say donate. I say organs.
You okay?
I say organ, you say donate. Organ. Organ. Tissue, you say donate. Tissue. Tissue. I say organ, you say donate. Organ. Okay, guys, we got some fresh air.
That's it.
Oh, oh, oh. Oh, no.
Can we get your students up front somehow, just to make sure they're kind of leading the way as well? Yeah, jump ahead.
Oregon, you say donate. Oregon, Oregon.
Donate.
I say two shoes, you say donate. Two shoes,
donate.
Donate. I say Oregon, you say donate.
So just you guys stay up here, make sure you're paying attention so that the kids are all walking in the right direction,
yeah.
And the police officer will give you instructions. Okay. Phil. You're going to be getting a lot of phone cameras when you get into more populated areas. A lot of people are going to start snapping their... And if anybody asks this, just tell them very simple. We're trying to, you know, encourage everybody to be an organ donor. This way? Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Do we turn here?
No, just keep straight.
Keep going straight? Okay.
Whoa! This is a trip of life! How's everyone doing?
Keep your eye on the flame. When it's going down, get the lamp oil. If we can get that going in the populated areas.
Right, right.
Watch your step. The kids are gonna jump in the bus, the younger kids. As soon as we hit North Capitol, it's by the VA Medical Center. Okay, so here we are in DC, Washington, DC, doing the pre-kickoff of the newest campaign for Step by Step.
Let's go.
Eighth campaign, the world.
Let's go.
SOS the World. We're coming throughout 200 countries, and it's all starting here in Washington, D.C. We're going to come back for September 10th.
I say Oregon, you say donate. Oregon, donate. Oregon, donate. I say you say donate.
Thank you. keep your eye on that flame, David.
Pretty soon.
Yeah, because we're going to refill it pretty soon. Okay. Is it okay if you hold on to it?
Yeah.
You can have somebody else hold on to it.
That's fine. Just
okay. What? One of the kids is carrying it. But David, you have to get a cup to put on. Keep walking. Come here, David. There's a cup, a milk cup, inside the little cabinet. Is it open, that cabinet?
The closet?
Yeah. Because what you do is take that, put that cup, hold that cup so when we're ready to put it out, and then refill it. But we got to find a convenient spot. I don't want to do it. Camera, I'll do it.
Okay.
Ah, nice. Hey, do you need this?
We got it. Hold on to this. I'll take care of it. Keep walking.
I need the cloth. I need a glove in the side. I need a glove in the side.
Oh, no, it's not.
I need a glove. Yeah, okay.
I got later.
Ready?
Who's holding the torch?
I am.
Okay. Bigger. Watch the branches.
All right. We got it.
Yeah.
Okay, that cup we don't need anymore.
Stuck on my shoe.
Watch the branches. Do a low ball. Blood?
Oil.
You got blood? No, it's okay. That'll dry up. You're okay.
All right. Watch.
Hey, no, no. Please.
Don't touch your face with your hands. That's all. Is the Starbucks cup back in the thing? It's, okay. Missing it. No. What do you think? Is this working out? Yeah, you guys are doing great.
He's doing it.
Really? It never fails, David. Every time I ask the teachers to supervise, they get too much into it and they forget their response. So I always got to keep that extra eye, you know what I'm saying? That's why it looks like, you know, I gotta keep mannerly and keep focused on these kids. Watch the torch. Just low.
When I say tissue, you say donate. Tissue. Tissue. When I say organ, you say donate. Organ. Organ. That was great. When I say organ, you say donate. Organ.
Your own creativity, mister. Are you guys doing okay?
Yep.
Everybody's doing okay?
Donate.
Good,
donate.
Good.
Donate.
Donate. Donate. Donate.
Donate. You. What do you think? You guys are doing great. Wish we would have had more media coverage. This is a positive story. They want to cover all the negative stuff.
When I say organs, you say donate. Organs!
Let's go.
Donate to organs, let's go. Donate to organs, let's go. Donate to organs, let's go. Donate to organs, let's go. Donate to organs, let's go. Donate to organs, let's go. Donate to organs, let's go.
Mrs. North, I think they came prepared. I think they came prepared. Remember, when we get closer to the population, that's when you got to give it your all.
Okay.
All ready? Good job.
Bye.
We're hold on.
Thank you.
I might have to refill that. Also at the Capitol, at the reflection pool.
What is this?
This is donating organs. It's going around the world, 200 countries. That torch was blessed by Pope John Paul II. And at the Capitol, there should be some senators there waiting to receive it. That torch higher. So I'm gonna have to do it now. Okay, you gotta hold this.
I got it.
It's on, I think. Check.
It's on.
Donate.
Right?
I'll get that.
I'll just say the same thing over and over again.
Okay, it'll be okay. It'll blend in.
Here you go.
Babe, look at this. Hold on. I'll fix it. David. David. Hold it. Who's got the cup?
They have the cup.
When I say take the loose, say.
The letter's in there.
When I say take the loose, say. Hey, David.
on.
Is it on?
Thank you.
Organ donations. There's a crisis with an organ shortage in America. There's someone's dying every hour because they're not receiving an organ.
Donate.
When you get home, go to step by step. .ca. Can you remember that?
Yeah.
You remember that?
Yeah.
You'll see everything under. Yeah. Now's when you really got to pump it out. You really got to keep going with this. Which one? Are you guys tired?
Yeah.
No? They said that you couldn't make the whole thing. I guess you're proving them wrong, eh?
Yeah.
Good for you. We're almost there.
Oh, yeah.
To go where?
The Capitol Reflection Pool.
Right here.
Yeah, they're going to lead us right there. Somebody's got to keep an eye on the flame. David. Washington, D.C., the capital.
Let's go!
I'll stand still.
Excuse me. Okay.
Are you taking pictures, David? Where's the best place they can park two vehicles?
That's the whirlpool right there.
Okay, where could they park, like, just for about 15 minutes, the ambulance and the bus?
What is this top of the hill? Police, let me find one of the...
We just need about 15 minutes of parking.
Let's go! Next, Dylan.
Okay, we're all gonna... Sorry, guys. We're all gonna gather over here.
When I say donate, you say... When I say organ, you say donate.
Can you have every... David! Have everybody stop here for a second at this corner.
I can't hear you.
Can you find them a temporary parking spot? Can you find them a temporary parking spot just for about 50 minutes, the bus and the ambulance? Just over here, somewhere here?
Yeah, the bus and the ambulance.
Okay. Follow him.
Can't hear you guys.
Yeah, right here. Yep.
When I say everybody, do say donate. Everybody.
Donate.
Okay, can I get everybody's attention? Is everybody here? Okay, everybody's here, right? Yep. Okay.
This office is going to be down there.
Yeah.
It's going to be a sidewalk leading straight into the pool.
That's where they're going to walk? Yeah. So they're going to walk down here?
Yeah, there's going to be a sidewalk to your left.
Yep, to the left.
Everybody's going
to
walk inside that sidewalk.
Okay.
And straight to the pool, right?
And the ambulance and the bus will be okay?
Yeah, park? Pull up over this way.
Okay, right. Okay, perfect. Okay, listen up, everybody. First of all, congratulations to your school and everybody else, but your school especially, because they weren't supposed to do the whole thing, and they did the whole thing, so, you know. Okay, now we're gonna make our final steps to the reflection pool. When we get there, we're gonna do another group photo op in front of behind the Capitol, in front of the Capitol. And we're going to also get everybody on videotape with holding the torch, saying how you felt about this very briefly, what it meant to you. And if you had a wish, who would that wish be to pass the torch to? So I know a lot of people are going to probably say Obama, and that's okay. Or a lot of people are going to say celebrities, or a lot of people are going to say whoever you want to say, because we're going to try and make that wish happen. All right? Okay, so let's march on our final steps.
Hey, my name is Kendall. We're going to go to
we're on TV.
We're going to go to the reflection pool.
Hey, maybe we can get a sneak preview. Who would you like to see that torch pass to?
We would like to see that torch pass to Barack Obama, the Black President of the United States.
Very good. And you?
I would like Obama to be the president.
Okay, let's get your name.
My name is Kenneth Proctor, and I'm in the third grade.
Sorry? Okay, and your name?
My name is LeMajorin Samana, and I'm in the third grade.
Great.
We're on our way right now.
We're going to go turn over here. Right here. Get everybody to turn here. So stand point there. Wave them to come this way.
Johnny's mother coming.
Where?
Right there.
Where?
Right there.
Okay, you're going to start the lineup over here, right in front of the Capitol, and face this way. Okay, right there, and look this way. That's where everybody's gonna start gathering. We're gonna gather all over here.
Thank you.
just for a sec. I need you to help me get these kids pumped to sing for the last time. Those okay. two jingles.
Okay, gotcha.
Well, as soon as they all get here.
Okay.
Hey guys and girls, listen up. When everybody gets here, we're gonna sing the jingle for the last time at the end of the leg, okay?
So you gotta give it everything you got.
Gotta be loud.
Wish we would have had some water here. That would have been good, eh? Next time. These are real soldiers. Sorry, it's a little dirty.
That's all right, man. This is all right.
Yeah, your kids did great.
Your
kids did great.
Yeah, man.
Fantastic. So we'll go with your school first to get each student to say something. We'll get them, if you can, we'll start with your school, start calling out the names.
All right.
But first we're going to do a couple of jingles, and
okay,
Aaron's going to lead it off.
Okay, what's the
donate your organs. Let's go, clap, clap. Okay, but help me with that.
Okay.
Okay, so we're going to give it everything we have, because we want everybody to hear this. The two jingles that we've been saying on the road. Okay, the first one is donate your organs. Let's go, clap, clap. Donate your organs. Let's go, clap, clap.
Donate your organs. Let's go. Donate your organs. Let's go. Donate your organs. Let's go.
I say I say tissue. You say donate.
Tissue.
Donate.
Tissue.
Donate.
When I say organ, you say donate.
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 Organ.
Donate.
When I say tissue, you say
donate.
Tissue.
Donate.
Tissue.
Donate.
When I say organ, you say donate. Organ.
Donate.
Organ. Donate.
Yay. 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 Okay, now we're going to start with the prep school first. You can select each student. Remember, make it very brief. Say your name. And then briefly what this meant to you and who you would like that torch passed. And okay. Each person's going to touch the
all
torch.
All right, very quickly.
First
come
person,
on,
go ahead.
Come here, come here, come here. So you can take Wisma's hand.
Okay, go ahead. What did this mean to you?
What did this mean to you?
Organ and tissue donation. Cool, was it cool? You could say cool.
It was cool.
It's cool.
All
okay,
right.
And who do you want, hold on, who do you want that torch passed to? If you had somebody, who would you want that to be?
My school.
Your school, perfect.
Right,
that's going to happen.
Like
September
right,
10th.
What did this mean to you?
This felt very good.
Okay, and who would you
like? Who would you like this torch pass to?
Barack Obama.
All right.
All right.
We're going to make that happen.
All right.
Go ahead.
How did you feel about coming in with the torch today?
Good.
You feel good? And who would you like to pass this? Who would you like to pass this on to?
Barack Obama.
Okay. All right.
Next.
Let's make sure Barack Obama hears this.
Yeah. He will. You guys are going to write to him.
Okay.
My name is Jamal. This man's left me. My aunt had recently, like 10 years ago, gave her kidney to my grandma. So I guess I have fun.
Okay.
Connection here.
Okay.
Yeah, good. Who do you want that torch passed?
Who do you want that torch passed to?
Whoever wants it.
Okay. Whoever needs it, right?
Whoever needs it. All right. Come on.
It was fun, and I would like to switch to Michelle Obama.
Alrighty. Okay, we're going to write to her.
All right.
You guys got to help us.
About your event today.
How did it feel? What did it do to
you? What did it feel like?
My name is Shawnee Jackson, and it felt good.
And who do you want to see this passed on to?
Okay. All right. Okay. Next.
Okay. Your name? And how did you feel about coming out today? All right. About tissue and organ donation. Who'd like to see this torch passed on to?
Myself.
Okay. That's cool.
No. Your name?
Oh, my name is Eric Folsom. And how I feel today is that I think everybody should have a second chance in life. Donate your organs and tissue.
very good. Very
torch, good. Torch passing to.
Who do you want to pass the torch to?
Eric. Eric, who do you want that pass the torch to? Okay.
Good one. Your name?
My name is Wasilla.
And what did it mean for you to come out today? What did it mean?
Did you have fun?
Yeah.
Okay.
Who do you want
to pass the torch to? Okay. All right. Very good. Your name? And how did you feel about today?
I felt good about today.
Alright, who'd you like to see the torch pass to?
The young kids, the young generation under me,
right.
And everybody else.
Very good.
Okay.
Your name?
Michael.
And how you feel about the walk today?
I feel very thankful.
Very thankful? Very good. And who would you like to see the torch pass to?
I would like to see the torch pass to Leslie.
Okay.
My name is Kenna Fox. I would like to pass the torch to Barack Obama.
How you feel about the walk today?
Excited.
All right.
Nice.
Good. All right. Come on.
That was an excellent escort.
And what do you think about the walk today? You think, how do you feel?
Excited.
Okay, and who would you like to see the torch pass to?
Obama.
All right, we have a lot of Obama fans.
Yeah.
All right, and your name?
Leslie.
All right, and how you feel about the walk today?
Good.
And you feel good about it? Okay, who'd you like to see this passed on to?
Obama.
Okay. All right, who's next? Come on.
My name is LaMaja Williams, and I feel good about the walk today.
All right, who'd like to see it passed to?
Barack Obama.
All right.
That's my boy.
Pretty popular. Okay, your name?
Honolulu.
All right, and what did you think about the march today? It was great. Okay, anything else you want to say about the march? All right, who'd like to see the torch pass? Come on.
My name is Issa Glimmer. I'm from Wasilla High School. And I feel like today this cause is worth my time for those who are less fortunate than I am. And I'd like this torch to be passed to one of my homies.
Ivory Dante. Who else? Ivory Dante. Come on. I would like to say that this is
an honor because it's helped millions of people around the world. And I agree with John Paul's saying about it being a symbol of love, taking from the Morgans and tissues, that they have a significant amount of love to the person they're giving it to. I wouldn't know exactly who to give the torch to, but I would give it to someone who really appreciates life, all kinds of life, and maybe even someone who had a...
God bless you.
Come on, real quick. My name is
Avery.
And what did the walk mean to you today?
Everybody.
Who'd you like to see the torch passed on to?
Antonio.
My name is Al.
Come on, my name
is Ghost.
All right, and what does the march mean to you today?
The march means a lot to me because there's a lot of people out there that need kidney transplants that no one will donate.
Very good. And who'd you like to see that pass on to?
Wait,
no, who'd you like to see?
Who's your hero?
My hero is my great grandma that passed from cancer.
Okay, very good. Come on, quickly, you gotta get on the bus.
Yeah, just gonna go for that school because the bus is.
All right.
Oh, which school is that? Archbishop? Archbishop?
Okay.
After.
And what did the march mean to you today? What does the march mean to you today?
It means a lot because
people eat organs, and I think that's a nice thing.
Hey, who'd you like to see it passed on to? Who would you like to pass the torch on to?
Who's your hero?
I would like to pass the torch.
Who's your hero?
Oh, my hero is my mom.
Okay, we're going to do Archbishop now because they got to get going right away. Okay. What did you feel about the campaign?
I felt that this march was very good because it gives an insight to people who don't know much about donor tissue donation.
And who would you like to pass the torch to, sir?
My grandparents.
Good for you. Okay, next. Sorry.
Who next?
How did you feel about the campaign?
It's very useful because we need to raise awareness of organ donations to people. There's thousands of American people who
okay, who would you like to pass the torch to?
The Redskins.
Okay.
Yep.
Go ahead. Your name?
My name is Joel.
How'd you feel about the campaign?
I think it made a really big impact in my life and in all the people that I know, because I'm going to tell them about it, you know. And I actually made the decision to be an organ donor.
Good for you.
I want to pass the torch to the people in the Pentagon, because they're one of the reasons that most of the people, you know, lose their organs.
Yeah, we need their support.
Yeah,
Maybe we can do that one on September 10th. We can get them all out here. That's going to be our mission.
Thanks a lot.
Okay. Your name? How did you feel about the campaign?
My name is Garrison Best, and okay. I felt that the campaign was a very good cause to help people that need organs and tissue to be better. And I want to pass this to the survivors of the war.
Good for you. Good for you. Bless you. Do we got anybody else from prep?
Yes.
Dante.
Yes.
Dominique.
Okay, your name? Your name?
My name is Dante Middleton.
And what did the walk mean to you today? How do you feel about the walk?
Did you have fun?
Yes.
Yeah?
Okay. Did it? Go ahead.
That's good. So it did something for you, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Right, okay. Who's your hero?
The generation under me.
Very good.
Good.
Very good. Come on, Dominique.
What did you say? The generation under me.
Dominique. All right, and how do you feel about the walk today?
Great. It's good.
Okay. And what do you mean to you?
Peace.
Okay. Who's your hero? Who'd you like to pass that torch on to?
Barack Obama.
Barack Obama.
Okay.
All right.
Where's Mrs. North?
Mrs. North. My name is Richard Reeves, and I'm from a preparatory school, and I was honored that we were selected to participate in the walk. I think it gave our school a different sense of awareness to tissue and organ donation. We were very proud and honored to be a part of this. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Can we have Mrs. North here, too, and all the staff?
Come on, Mrs. North.
Ms. North.
Ms. North, Mr. Henry.
No, she's asking.
Just for a quick minute. Okay, Mrs. North, we're hoping you can join us back in September 10th, and we're hoping we can put you on a mission from here until September 10th. If we can get your school to all write letters to President Obama to be here September 10th when we arrive, because we're going to do the same thing, but we want to get President Obama here to receive the torch. Can we get your school to write letters? Does that work? Okay. Okay.
Hi, I'm from the Preparatory of DC, and I've enjoyed participating in this Torch for Life and the Donate Organs and Tissues today. I learned a lot about what is happening, and I'm looking forward to this getting even bigger and better and being back with you on September 10th. Thank you.
Thank you. Anybody else? You're not in a hurry, right?
Well,
kind of. Okay, right neck. Right your neck.
Yeah.
Okay, sorry.
Okay. My name is Wilbert Henry. I'm from the Preparatory School of Washington, D.C. And I'm very happy to participate in this walk today. And I want everybody to realize that it is very important to give, donate an organ, because it can save a life. So it's very important that everybody considers to donate.
Who would you like that torch passed to? Okay, there you go.
Anderson.
Hi, I'm Miss Anderson. I'm one of the staff from Preparatory School. And I just want everybody to donate their organs and their tissue.
And who would you like to see that torch pass to?
Pass to, I'd like to see it pass to my great grandparents.
Oh, nice. Okay, is that it with prep?
That's it.
That's it? Okay, now we got. I'm going to stay in touch with you. We got to stay on this mission.
Okay.
Once you get
situated,
okay.
Call me back.
Okay.
We'll do those letters.
Okay, perfect. Okay, did it go out? We're going to put it back on.
There's still a little bit.
Actually, tip it a little bit. There we go. Okay, that's good. Okay. The final four, like they say in March Madness?
Yeah.
Okay.
Ben Moniz, I guess if I could pass the torch on to anybody, be everybody in America who doesn't have that little organ donor thing on their driver's license, because I think it's really important that people along with that just save a life. Alrighty.
How did this feel, the whole campaign? Like the whole, how do you feel? Like, what did it do to you?
Nice day, good walk, nice torch.
Perfect.
Alrighty.
Okay, next.
I'm Alex Jankovic, and I'm glad I could come out here today and spread the awareness of being an organ donor. If I could pass the torch, I'd give it to Barack Obama, because he can reach everyone in America and the world, and deliver the message.
Thank you. Next. Our DJ.
My name's Garrett Jansen, go St. Anselm's. This is a great organization, great cause. I want to give it on to Benedict the 16th.
Wow.
Have him carry it on.
Okay.
Keep the church involved.
Nice. Very nice. Next.
Hello. Well, my name is Diego Jones, and it's a great time to be here with all these people who have been helped so much by these transplants, and to know that this event that I'm taking place in is sort of making a difference, and that is very nice to us. I think I would like to pass this off to our president, who's behind us and helping us.
Perfect. Great. Aaron.
Yes, sir.
We're going to put every school on a mission. I want to get you. Oh, thank you. So we're going to stay in touch. We're going to stay in touch with Richard. We got to make that happen. We got to get the president here on September 10th. We got to make that happen. We got to believe that can happen. Oh, sorry.
Yeah, no, you don't know.
Thank you.
Yeah, we got to make that happen. So I'll stay with Richard. I'll keep. Okay. Sorry, Aaron.
That's fine. That's okay. I just want to say my name is Aaron Bell. I'm the latest member of the SOS America team. I'm truly, truly honored and grateful to be here today. This was an explosive and dynamic experience today. It has changed my whole entire perspective on the way that I view organ and tissue donations, and it is a phenomenal foundation. Please go out, promote the word, promote the good news, tell your pastors, tell your schools, tell your community how important this is, because we can save a life today, one person at a time.
Thank you, Aaron. Alex.
All right, give me some hugs.
Yes.
So, my name is Alex Morse from St. Anselm's Abbey School. This relay meant a lot to me. My sister has had two liver transplants, and she wouldn't be here if it weren't for those donors out there.
Thank you. Good meeting.
And I'd like to pass this torch on to my 16-month-old son, Sam.
Wow. God bless you. You know what? We're going to make that happen on September 10th. Can we?
Excellent. I plan to.
Okay. Perfect. Perfect. I think that's it. Oh, sorry. David, your wife. The officers. We'll see if we can get them to say a few words. David, you want to ask them? If they'll say a few words? Thank you.
1 o'clock.
And it's 25 Tuesday.
Yeah. Okay, go ahead.
I'm David Miller, and this is my wife, Daphne Miller. This program that George is working on is the best thing in the world, because if it wasn't for this, I wouldn't be here today, because I've had to have a heart transplant 8 years ago.
How did it feel driving the truck of life?
It was great.
You did great.
It was terrific.
You did.
All the kids,
you did great.
They're in there doing the talking.
It wasn't that nice. Doesn't that? I mean, what? I just can't believe there was no media here. Oh well, we'll get them on September 10th.
Yeah.
Okay. You guys were great. Did the officers? No. Nope. Okay.
They're not. They gotta go.
Yeah, no problem. Perfect. Okay, we got a star cup it. Starbucks cup it. Starbucks cup.
Has that been around since 10 years ago in Rome as well? Or?
Oh, yeah, that was actually.
The cup, I mean.
Oh, not the cup. One was Starbucks. No, we were using another one.
Last week. He was some new back in the day. That's what we had. So, we had a bug back in the day. You must have known that, huh?
Yeah. Okay, that's the way it should be.
I mean, we might have a lot of police officers around here, but still.
That's right. That's good. Okay, so we're going to start piling in. So we somehow might have to do this a little strategic. There's a couple of for the ladies to sit on.
All right. I can sit on the floor. Don't matter to me. Thank you.
I know the way back pretty well. Do you want me up front?
Yeah, we can get two guys up, or maybe even three if you guys are skinny.
I know you get there pretty well.
Yeah, okay, good.
Skinny guys up front?
Hey there.
Why isn't it,
You're gonna go ahead. I'll come in at the end. It's gonna be a little tight, but I think it's the only option. The bag's here somewhere. Yeah, just put that on the side. So just hang on to something.
Yeah. If he could sleep in an ambulance, he can
already
sleep anywhere.
Yes. That's amazing.
He's got pretty good practice from your boss.
I'm just joking.
Okay, we're on the 95 North, just leaving Washington, D.C., heading up to back to New York City. And we got about 2.5 hours to go, 3 hours, no, 2.5. And I was just saying that, well, first of all, what a dynamite. Like, that was like dynamite. What just happened in D.C.? Washington, D.C. Why is it that a half hour ago, I felt the entire high from that Washington, and now we're a half hour later, and it's gone that high. It's like I can't even express how I feel right now about what we just did, the same way I could have if I would have did it right after the event. Does that happen to you? Yeah. Or do you still feel what you felt back then?
I still feel it. It's sustained. Something that you told me a long time ago about when you're on the high, you just, you know, you try not to
stay too high,
and that way
find the middle ground.
When you come down from that, you don't have as far to come down.
Yeah.
So you even it out all the way through, and that's the way I feel right now. And I, you know, of course, I'm concentrating on
the road as well.
So,
yeah. I understand.
And,
well,
I don't need a pee break right now, so.
Okay. Well, that was a hell of an event.
Yeah, it was really. It was amazing. We had about 75 people who walked 4 miles through the heart of, not exactly the heart of Washington, but certainly downtown Washington, D.C., one of the most, if not the most powerful city in the world. The seat of the biggest political power in the world, for sure. And we engaged over 50 school kids to walk with the torch, and they knew knew exactly what they were doing there and why they were there. And it wasn't just to get out of school for a couple of hours, which I'm sure school kids definitely factors into it. But at the same time, they knew exactly why they were there. And when they were asked questions, they may have been shy about answering, but they knew how to answer the questions. Even if it was just, I feel good, you know. Well, why do you feel good? Because we're trying to help something. And that's the big part of it is how the kids feel. And giving it over to them because they're the future. We're just here to facilitate that.
Talk about that magic feeling though of being in the middle of Washington, D.C. with all that police escort, stopping all that traffic through the major artery of Washington to the Capitol, where if anything happens at the Capitol, that's the world, that's a microphone for the world. Right in front of the Capitol, with the heart of the city's kids, and saying what they were saying, that they want Congress and they want Obama to receive that torch next time we come there, and that they're gonna make it happen, and that and the police, what did they say about it, how good they felt? Did you see them get into it?
Yeah, they said that was their favorite activity as a police officer, was to do exactly what they did today, which was help us walk that 4 miles and get from.
They had smiles on their face. They were so into it. They kept giving us the thumbs up at every stop. At every, you know, they kept even chanting, getting into it. You know, I mean, what just happened? It's going to hit you more when you see the video.
Yeah.
It's going to hit me more.
So watch the video.
And all the love, all the people that were there, Aaron, David, can't have a more contrast. You know, from the South, Southerners, we were just talking about that yesterday. They could be our perfect spokespeople for the South. Hey, David?
Yeah.
There are our Southern spokespersons. They can get the...
They're
like, people.
Kind of like what I did in D.C., they can do down South.
Yeah. Right?
Yeah.
I mean, the rest is going to be easy to get the rest. It's easy to get California, to get the mid-country in, Northern... you know, that's the South was the only, you know.
It's an unknown quantity.
Yeah, so, but these guys are going to start rounding up our army in the South. Right?
Yeah. That's going to be a very, very interesting experiment. And, I think we should go to, well, I don't know about me, but go to Knoxville. My cousin who just died, her husband lives in Knoxville, and he will help out, and I'll get him on board.
We will.
Knoxville. And,
I wish Glenn was with us. That's the only bad part today. Glenn should have been there. I know he couldn't make it. Something's up. I hope he's okay. So I gotta phone him again just to make sure at least he's okay, or to give him, or if he needs any help or something.
Well, I just hope that things are good between him and his family. That's all.
Well, if they're not, you know, that he's okay, you know? Because he can always bounce, you know what I mean?
Services, and this does not allow me to sleep easy, because there are instances where
I heard the girls are